doing today? That was pathetic. I think we can do better than that. I said, how are we doing today? There we go. Boy, the spirit of the season has a hold of me like a bad rash that just won't go away. I am here today to deliver a festive and not at all inappropriate seasonal holiday tale that is guaranteed to jingle your holiday bells. Doesn't that make you feel all warm and cozy? Huh? Who wants to hear a festive tale straight from the free domain? It's called public domain. I lost the word, but it's fine. This story is all about the jolly old man in the red suit, and it is brought to you by Disney Plus. That's right, everybody. Disney Plus paid to keep us here for the holidays. So check out all the quality programming available only on Disney Plus. Disney Plus. Is that enough pandering? No, my text says no. I'll come back for it later. Now that I feel extra dirty and could use a shower, this story is also known as 'Twas the Night a Strange Magical Man Shimmied Down My Tight Little Chimney, or a very special holiday episode of Two Guys, a Girl, and a Pizza Place. Now to the story. Oh, it's so good. One person got that joke. Now you know quality TV right there. All right. 'Twas the night before Christmas, and all through the safe house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. Not Electra or Blade or that guy named Gambit, who said, I'm about to make a name for myself up here. Boy, I could not understand it. Seriously, he sounded like a washing machine full of tennis shoes. The stockings and holsters were well hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that old Santa Pool soon would be there. Dog Pool was nestled asleep in his bed. Visions of face licking danced in his head. Wolverine wore his cowl. He'd waited 20 years to wear it. Peter Pool just a crop top. And the rest, oh, he bared it. When out on the lawn, there arose such a clatter, they all leapt from the beds to see what was the matter. Away to the window they flew like a flash. Although we probably should have said Quicksilver there due to the IP issues. They ripped open the shutters and tore down the sash. Oh, it doesn't rhyme with Quicksilver, now I know why they did it. The moonlight reflected on the soft fallen snow, giving luster of midday to the objects below. Boy, this is a wordy poem. I'm gonna skip these next parts, they're really boring. And what to their wondering eyes should appear but a shiny red sleigh and 8 awesome doping deer. There was a fast-talking driver, all red, black, and cool. They knew in that moment that it was Santa Pool. It's one of Santa Pool's furry little elves.
Yeah. All right, come on. Get on your little horse, Bob, and let's go.
That is not a horse. This is a magical, mythical flying reindeer corn. Where's your sense of childish wonderment?
Let's wrap this up, okay?
Wow, someone's going to be on the naughty list this year. You are just a grumpy little gumdrop. Can't you show a little bit of Christmas cheer for all the children and the Disney adults? Not a noise for the children, but you cheer for yourselves. That's wonderful, great. This guy right here has been waiting his entire adult life to see you and I pal around like some bad buddy cop film.
Some life you got, man. Some life. All right, fine. But I'm not singing any carols.
Oh, we'll see about that, Wolvie.
No, we won't.
All right, we are in this together now. It's time to deck these halls. You want a hat?
No, keep the hat.
Okay. This is right there. Perfect. Okay.
All right. So, Santa Claus.
Santa Pool. Yeah, you have to stick with the magic and the branding. I'm going to call call you Wolvie Pool.
Just don't.
Okay.
Santa Pool. Yeah. His eyes, how they twinkle.
Wow! Could you phone it in any less right now? Aren't you some classically trained Broadway actor?
You got the wrong guy. All right, fine. Santa Pool, his eyes, how they twinkle. His dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses. His nose, like a cherry. He had an obnoxious red suit and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. Why would someone have a bowl full of jelly?
Because it rhymes, Wolvie. It's a children's poem. Stop looking into it so much. And honestly, from now on, don't call this my belly. Call it my jugger gut.
Okay, stop that right now. Stop.
Okay,
stop.
Sorry.
He spoke not a word. Yeah, right. And went straight to his work. He filled all the stockings like a merry old jerk.
Merc! The line is Merc.
It's not. It's not. He laid a finger beside his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney, he rose.
All right. Huge climax now, Wolvie.
Relax.
He mounted his magical reindeer corn and gave a hearty yee-haw. And away he flew faster than you ever saw. Do the line, Wolvie.
But I heard him exclaim as he flew out of sight.
Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night. Push me, Wolvie.
Absolutely not.
Okay.
Wait, that was kind of an abrupt ending. I mean, what about Dog Pool and those others? They were never brought up again.
Let me teach you something about working at the Disneyland Resort. Registered trademark. This is all fan service. Everything is fan service. It's like when we bring back the Main Street Electrical Parade every few years. Or those limited time oddball special event characters.
Great, well, then we're done here then.
Oh, no, we're not, Wolvie. We got extended through the holidays, thanks to Disney Plus. Happy holidays, everybody.
All right. Get on the horse right now.
No, I told you it's a reindeer corn.
On the horse.
If you watch Disney Plus, you would know.
Why do you keep saying Disney Plus?
I get paid every time I say Disney Plus, Wolvie.
Do I get paid too?
No.